NASA Railroad is located at the Kennedy Space Center in Cape Canaveral, Florida. The trackage starts at JJ Yard Interchange with the Florida East Coast Railway and ends south of the Vehicle Assembly Building. The railroad was initially developed to help with the construction of the Space Center and support the Apollo program's missions to the Moon, but soon evolved to primarily support the delivery of the solid rocket booster segments of the Space Shuttle program through its final launch in 2011. The Florida East Coast Railway Society's tour began at the railroad's maintenance facility, located just south of the Vehicle Assembly Building. The Society was given full access to document the facility and any remaining equipment in the yard. This included all three SW1500 locomotives the railroad owned, along with a variety of specially built rail cars that were developed especially for the space program. Following this, the operations portion of the visit began, with locomotive number 3 departing the facility. The train for the day would feature one of the unique aft skirt cars the railroad had built to carry one of the components of the solid rocket boosters. Once coupled to the car, the Society boarded the buses and hit the road to start the chase with the first stop at a nearby crossing.
Here we go.
The next location was at the entrance to the Saturn V Center, near the south end of the shuttle landing facility.
As he hits the crossing, it's a law.
I mean, as
he
hits the bus,
stop.
Oh,
supposed to blow all the way through.
Right here. Until the crossing's occupied.
One of the things I learned.
A bonus Runby was also captured along the road headed to our final destination. The final location was at Wilson Yard, just north of the shuttle landing facility. This location was used to store cars after they had been brought across the Indian River drawbridge. Due to the weight of the solid rocket booster cars, only a few could be brought across at a time. The cars were staged here until all of them were brought across to be assembled into a single train to continue onward. During this operation, the crew would use the yard to run around the aft skirt car.
For that reason, this last one of the three, they are making probably the last move of the railroad. 2 days from now, this is operation for the car.
Thank you.
Society's visit would come to an end with the departure of the train. The crew would return to the maintenance facility, officially bringing an end to the operations of the NASA Railroad. Since the closure, the railroad's equipment has been disposed of to multiple sources. Locomotive number 3 is now in Indiana. Locomotive number 2 is now in Miami, and locomotive number 1 is in Louisiana. Rail activity at the Space Center is not completely over, though. The Florida East Coast Railway provides service as needed, such as this special delivery for the Department of Defense. It has also participated in vibration testing that occurred when Port Canaveral was looking at getting freight service through the Space Center's property. In 2016, the Iowa Northern Railroad was contracted to help check for operational problems that might happen when unloading the upgraded booster segments for when the next generation of rail service begins to support the launches of the Space Launch System.